So our students have been learning about variables and data types in this lesson, particularly about integers and strings. Are there examples in the apps that you've worked on of these things?
Oh yes, there are plenty. Okay. So strings or integers are everywhere. In Gmail, for example, when you first open your email, it tells you how many unread messages that you have. Mm-hmm. So that's a very, very important number. And we actually have these very subtle bugs that the number might not match exactly how many unread messages you have. Hmm. So
I've never encountered that, have you?
That's good that you've never encountered it. So but these are, it's an interesting problem to solve because for Gmail, we actually sync that number first. Like mm-hmm. sync means like I'm fetching my data from the cloud mm-hmm. to my Android device. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So that data is actually, that number is synced separately from your actual email. So they could potentially go out of sync. Mm. And that's one of the very trickier issues to solve.
Okay, so we've established that the number of unread emails is a variable. Mm-hmm. Its data type would be?
It would be an integer.
It would be an integer. Yes. And its value is being calculated across devices, and its value is changing based on the use case or the scenario a user is experiencing.
Yes, exactly. Okay. And another use of integers, so that's an example of a variable integer, basically mm-hmm. it could change. Mm-hmm. Another example is IDs. Mm-hmm. So for IDs, it's actually very important that the integer stays the same.
So my email ID, particularly.
Exactly.
Email.
Okay. So the email ID on the server that represents that email needs to be exactly the same as the ID mm-hmm. that's on the client, because that's the way we uniquely identify this email everywhere across all your devices.
So this is for a conversation email, not like an email address.
Yes, for a conversation. So for in Gmail, for example, the whole thread, so the email thread, which has multiple messages in it, so the whole thread we call a conversation that has a conversation ID.
Okay.
And then each message itself also has its own unique ID.
Okay. And each one of these IDs is stored in a variable whose data type is?
Integer again.
Okay.
Yes.
How many emails are going out in a day? Do you know? Like, this is a lot of numbers.
Yes, I do not know on top of my head how many
but
emails.
I'd imagine that if each message in a conversation is unique, and each email is unique across all emails that are going,
this has got to be
a very large number, right?
So that's a very good question. So instead of an int, actually, for these, we use longs.
Okay.
So it's because it's 64-bit instead.
Okay.
So then we will never...
So long just gives you more space to hold a larger number.
Exactly.
That's really the difference between int and long. Okay.
Mm-hmm. How about any strings?
Strings.
I'd imagine, is subject a string at all, or how is that stored?
Yeah, everything... Yeah, subject is a string itself.
Okay.
And obviously, email addresses are strings, so that's another very important. And almost everything that you see in any app, like visually everything that has text, would be a string. And I think a good engineer, you don't have to know everything, but you have to be good at like figuring out like know where the answer. You can probably look for. There's a lot of good tutorials out there for. Just have to know how to look for the right keywords, search for the right keywords.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And do you also ask people for help?
Oh yes, that is actually very important. I think almost always I regret not asking people earlier. Mm-hmm. You know, I could like try to fix something for like a whole day and at the end of the day decide, okay, maybe I should have asked whoever wrote this component. Mm. So yeah, like I think reaching out to people early is definitely valuable, can save very valuable time. Mm-hmm. And also just be more aware of what other projects are going on at Google. I think at your own, around you. I think the really good engineers, they not only focus on what they're doing, but we have these things called tech talks at work. So
which are available publicly for people to view, at least some of them
are. Yeah, some of them are, yes. So they're often know what the latest technologies are, from these tech talks or announcements that are, sent to the entire engineering org. So just being on top of.
And let's go back to the time when you were actually learning to program. If you could talk to the Alice at that time, what advice would you give her today?
Wow, that's a very interesting question. I feel like I should have had more fun with programming. Mm. So I think the way I learned to program, and I think it's very different now, because I grew up in originally I'm from China. So I think it was very academically focused. Like, you know, I went to these extracurricular, you know, classes mm-hmm. that like taught by a teacher, and then, you know, we get assignments, like, you know, you do learn this algorithm and then, you know, do solve this problem. Mm-hmm. So, and I think looking back, I wish I had like done more projects or just like fun type projects. Mm-hmm. And I think.
Would you make a birthday app?
A birthday app? Oh, yes. And so, yeah, like exactly. Like, you know, these type of apps that I could have, I think I could learn a lot more, because it's not just about, you know, oh, there's this one right answer. Mm-hmm. But in like doing an app like that, I can learn like about design. If it's a birthday app, mm-hmm. I'll learn about, you know, different UI components. Mm-hmm. It's not just about, you know, okay, you need to send this data from here to here and then, you know, solve it more efficiently. Mm-hmm. And it's, yeah, I think it would, and I think in real life, that is what, you know, engineering is more about. It's about, you know, not just solving a technical challenge, but also mm-hmm. creating a great product.
Yeah, sort of like being driven by your own curiosity.
Yes, exactly. Yes.
Cool. Well, Catherine and I want to thank you for your time.
Oh, you're very welcome.
I think our students will benefit a lot from your perspective.
Yeah.